like and subscribe. On the way in the door, people. Today, at the request of one of my viewers, shout out to At God's Favorite, 6905. I had intended on doing this video anyway about Kobe Bryant versus LeBron James, because that is really the more realistic debate. That's a more realistic debate that you can have. Now, in my opinion, that's still not a debate either. But let's talk about it. But before we get into that, somebody made a comment in my When LeBron James Retired video. And I'm going to assume that he is a LeFan boy, because the comment he made was absolutely ridiculous. He said, basically, he said Kobe was never in the GOAT conversation, and that's something that started upon Kobe's death because they were trying to elevate him.
Now you see, now you done fucked up, you know that, don't you?
I'm assuming that you're a LeFan boy talking ridiculous stuff like that. That tells me two things. That tells me that either you weren't alive during Kobe's heyday, or you were too young to comprehend what was going on. Because the alternative other than that is that you just don't know what you're talking about at all. Kobe most definitely was in the GOAT debate. Sports shows, analysts, and everyone, when Kobe got to that fifth ring, there was talks of him surpassing Michael as the GOAT. And he also made some statement, how can you be the GOAT when you're not even the best at your position? Because if the decision had been made to crown Kobe the GOAT, that would also mean that he is now the best at his position. Now, obviously, we all know Michael Jordan is the GOAT. And, you know, I have to say that during the Kobe, when Kobe was in the GOAT conversation, to me, it was just recency bias. You know, and to be fair, Kobe was an exciting player to watch. You know, I remember, you know, some games Kobe was doing stuff that was reminiscent of MJ, and that gave you that similar feeling. But much like what will happen with LeBron when he retires, and well, that's actually happening to him now, when these younger kids are watching some of these highlight videos, which LeBron has to have some of the most boring highlight videos out there. But even with Kobe, as exciting as a player with Kobe is, so when you go back and watch Kobe highlights versus MJ highlights, MJ is just clearly, a step above everyone. And I love Kobe Bryant, which is why I say the eye test never fails. Or I should say the eye test rarely fails. You know, you can believe what your eyes are telling you. But anyway, let's get on to this Kobe versus LeBron thing, which is actually the more legitimate debate. And I have three quick points that I want to make without getting into stats. First of all, let me tell you why the stats thing between Kobe and LeBron is not a legitimate way to compare these two. Because of their trajectory when they came into the league. LeBron came into the league at a time when the league pretty much handed him the keys to the kingdom right out of high school. When Kobe came into the league wasn't doing that. The team wasn't doing that. Kobe had to earn his way. Kobe had to come off the bench. So in that sense, LeBron had a head start as far as just being able to take over the team, kind of have free reign, right? So their career paths were different, even though they both came out of high school. And, you know, it's not the fault of either one, but it is what it is. LeBron was able to take over the team. Kobe had to wait his turn. So, like I said, I have three things to address here. Number one thing that LeFan boys like to bring up to diminish Kobe's GOAT case, especially in comparison to LeBron, they try to bring up that he played with Shaq. And to this, I say, fanboys, the last thing you should ever be doing is bringing up the help that Kobe Bryant had when your king made the decision to go to Miami, play with D-Wade, Chris Bosh, and someone who often gets left out of that, Ray Allen. He goes back to Cleveland where he has Kyrie Irving and Kevin Love. Then he goes to the Lakers where he has Anthony Davis, wins the quarter ring, and then puts together what he himself deems as a championship team. He told everyone to keep that same energy. So I've said this on another video, fanboys, do not come in here telling me about how complaining about Russell Westbrook or telling me how Carmelo Anthony was old. Your king picked the team. Your king said keep that same energy when the season starts, as if this was definitely a championship caliber team. And he failed with that much talent. I don't care what excuses you make for it. That team should have been a championship caliber team. So do not talk about anybody else's help. So, yes, Kobe played with Shaq. And I will say for the first championship, Shaq was the definitive alpha. By the second championship, that was very much a partnership. And then Kobe's last two, Kobe was definitely the one and only definitive alpha on those championships. Now, this brings me to my next point. I have a question for you fanboys and fangirls all over the world. I have a question for you. That question is, when has LeBron carried a team across the finish line in the finals himself? When has LeBron James carried a team across the finish line himself during the finals? Because for at least three out of four of those times, he got saved. He got saved in Miami by Ray Allen. He got saved back in Cleveland from Kyrie. And he got saved for his one and only quarter ring, bubble ring, Disney ring in Los Angeles by Anthony Davis. Anthony Davis hit the biggest shot in that series. So fanboys, when has your king carried a team across the finish line in the finals? And before any of you bring it up, let me tell you about Michael Jordan passing to Steve Kerr or John Paxson. That was calculated decisions. Well, the first one, the Paxson, was drawn up by Phil Jackson saying, hey, if Paxson is open, if Paxson is going to be open, get it to him. The Steve Kerr play, Michael Jordan told Steve Kerr that, hey, if this happens, if they double team me, when they double team me, I'm coming to you. Be ready. And Steve Kerr said, I will be ready. That is a difference between LeBron throwing up a brick in Miami and then Miami getting the rebound and Ray Allen having the presence of mind to back up to the three-point line and save the day. That is a difference between Kyrie being the creator of his own shot because he's more fearless of the moment than LeBron James. And even though I feel like Anthony Davis has that same fear, in the bubble, he hit the biggest shot of that series. So when has your king carried a team across the finish line? Because Kobe Bryant was the definitive guy in his two championships without Shaq. And this alone, to me, is why I'm picking Kobe Bryant every single time. But last but not least, I think we all know where this is going. You all have seen it. The documentary on the Redeem Team. We all know who was the definitive alpha on that team. Kobe Bryant was the definitive alpha on that team. Kobe Bryant led the charge. Kobe Bryant set the tone. Kobe Bryant is the reason they brought home the gold. And again, I say, there's an interview where LeBron James himself admits that Kobe Bryant was the best player in the league. Fanboys. That's what your king said. Yeah, so at whatever point that LeBron was leapfrogged past Kobe, that was simply media-driven and narrative-created. Narratives for LeBron and narratives against Kobe. Kobe Bryant was more skilled than LeBron. Kobe Bryant was more fearless than LeBron. Kobe Bryant held his team accountable more than LeBron. Again, LeBron James has a passive-aggressive leadership style. Going back to the whole JR debacle and LeBron James, you know, couldn't pull it together to go into overtime. You know, he just acted like they just lost the game because JR made that mistake. I've said this time, a matter of fact, I'm doing a video on that. On that game, I'm doing a video on that. But yeah, you know, he couldn't look at JR, you know, just that passive-aggressive style. Like, if that was Jordan, he would have immediately checked JR. It was like, hey, man, get your head in the game. If that was Kobe Bryant, he would immediately check JR. Hey, get your head in the game. We going into overtime. Let's handle this. So yeah, to me, like I said, the more legitimate comparison is between LeBron and Kobe Bryant, but if I'm being honest, for me myself, that's not a comparison. I pick Kobe over LeBron 10 out of 10 times. There is no situation that I can think of to which I'm picking LeBron over Kobe. If I'm starting a team, I'm starting it with Kobe Bryant. Hey, fanboys, I know you think I'm on here just like dissing your guy, but really I'm trying to help you guys out. Like this is important. Like seriously, this is important in the sense that how can you count on someone who quits like that? How can you count on someone who quits like that? And he has a pattern of quitting. That's a serious problem. You know, if you've been watching my videos, you probably know that for me, that is my biggest issue with LeBron, is the fact that he has the ability to quit and leave situations. That's a problem. But anyway, I'm a hold up right here. You guys, let me know what you think in the comments. Who do you got? LeBron or Kobe or the Black Mamba, Mamba mentality. Which one are you taking? The King of Narratives or Mamba mentality? Let me know what you think. You all have a fantastic day, and I will see you next time. All right.